guys. I just want to come on here really quickly and make you guys a part of my Bible study, because as always, I'm in the bathroom doing my Bible study, and pardon my kids, they're being extra loud. I told them to quiet down, but they're just being extra loud. But anyway, and it's on Joshua specifically, chapter 1, verses 1 through 9. So that's your homework. Go to Joshua chapter 1, verses 1 through 9 and read them and write down everything that God gives to you. Now, this is what I've seen in these verses. I've read these verses so many times over and over again. One of my favorite verses in the Bible is Joshua 1:9. But when I was reading this, I was truly thinking about a lot of us and our situations and how we view things and how we think about things, right? So I'm going to read the first four verses to you really quickly. So it says, after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' aide, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now then, you and all of these people get ready to cross the Jordan River into the land I am about to give to them, to the Israelites. I will give you every place. Hold on, that's my husband. Sorry, y'all. I know I left off on reading, so I'm going to read verse 3. So, I will give you every place where you set your foot, as I promised Moses. Your territory will extend from the desert to Lebanon and from the great river, the Euphrates, all the Hittite country to the great sea on the west. Okay, I'm going to stop there for just a moment. So this is at a point where Moses died and Joshua was Moses' aide. Now what I was thinking was, God was looking at Joshua the whole time. There was a reason why he was the aide to Moses. Being that he was his aide, he was probably very close to Moses. If you remember the story in Numbers, I think it's chapter 13 or 14, don't quote me, I think it's 13, where Caleb and Joshua went over into the promised land, checked it out, came back, and gave Moses a report. These two men, Joshua and Caleb, went over with a group of Israelites, and they went and scoped out the land. And Joshua and Caleb came back and they said, yeah, let's go in. Let's take the possession of this land. The fruit is great. It's flowing with milk and honey. This is just awesome. And then the Israelites were like, no, we don't need to go take it over. These guys are giants. The fruit is not that great. The land is not that great. We need to hold back. We need to hold back. So Joshua and already had the spirit of let's go. You know, he had ambition. He had motivation, so to speak. He already had that in his heart. God had already placed that in his heart. So when it was time for him to succeed over Moses, after Moses had died, God already knew his heart. God already had put that zeal in him to take over the land. So he chose Joshua. Imagine how many of us are like the Israelites, and we're just making up every excuse in the world to not do what God has called us to do, or to not do what God has promised us he was going to do for us or give us or whatever it might be. We're just making up every excuse in the world. We're just, oh no, it doesn't look good. It's not the right time. The fruit is bad. You know, those are just big giants. There's no way we can overtake them. You know, you're looking at the giants in your life and whatever it might be, whatever you're going through, and you're just like, no, I can't do it. I can't do it. Then you're never going to do it. You're always going to sit there wondering what if I could do this? You're going to always be accepting your current circumstances, and you're not going to move. You're not going to budge. So when it comes time, like in Joshua's situation, he was only the aide. Moses is dead. God said that Moses, my servant, is dead. He said, he's dead. It's finished. I'm now making you. He said, now then you and all these people get ready to cross the Jordan River and into the land I'm about to give to them, to the Israelites. He said, now is the time that I want you to get ready and take over this land. Do not be afraid, is what he goes into in verses 5 through 9. Do not be afraid. Be strong and courageous. Don't let anything hold you back. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. So imagine if you're the person that's just, it's not a good time. It's not a good time. And then when it is the time, God can't use you. God can't make you go. He can't put you in a position like he did Joshua and change your life suddenly into a leader because you have that stink attitude. I can't do it. this just looks bad. I can't overcome this. No, you need to be like Joshua and like Caleb, where let's take possession over this today. Even if it's not the time yet, you got to have that heart. Like, you know, one day is going to be the time. One day I'm going to see through the situation. One day my finances are going to get better. One day my health is going to get better. I'm going to beat this cancer. I'm going to get my health back together. I'm going to lose this weight. You know, I'm going to make my marriage work. I'm going to turn this around. I'm going to get out of this town that I've lived in for 80 years. I'm going to get out of this town and I'm going to see the world. I'm going to travel. I'm going to do so much for God and His kingdom. I'm going to break through those. That's the kind of attitude that you've got to have, because any moment, at any time, God is a suddenly God. Just like He changed Joshua's life from an aide to a leader, you've got to be ready to become the leader in your life. Okay? You're not going to stay the aide the rest of your life unless you will it to be that way. If you stay in that stink attitude where this is just all I'm going to get in life, this is all I'm going to accept, this is it, you know, I'm just let the devil defeat you. In other words, that's where you're going to stay for the rest of your life. We need to be more like Joshua and rise up. Our lives are going to change suddenly, okay? And it's going to be to take the Israelites into the promised land, into the things that God has promised you in your life. That's what's going to happen. But you have to have the mentality and the belief and the faith to push through, no matter what situation you're facing right now. You know, even if you lost a loved one, I feel like there are some people that have just lost loved ones and their life is just defeated. Just like God said, Moses is dead. Your loved one has passed on into a better place. You still have a purpose here to fulfill. So you've got to take it with you, of course, you know, grieve over it. But then you've got to go past that and remember that God still has something for you to do on this earth. You're still here, okay? And you may have gotten that doctor's report and it's just like, man, my cancer, it has spread. It's not gotten better. It's gotten worse. Man, I'm gonna die. You know, there's nothing else left for me. No, as long as you still have a breath in your body, you can still beat and overcome that cancer. Do a self-evaluation, whatever it is that's causing that cancer. If it's health bad, change your eating habits. Start walking around. If it's diabetes you might be facing, start walking around. Do whatever it takes to make the change in your life, to overcome whatever giant it is that you're facing in your life. Don't stay stuck, because at any moment, at any time, at any place, at any space, God can change your life suddenly. All of a sudden, everything can change. Everything. It can be just like Joshua. Okay, Joshua, Moses is dead. I want you to lead these people into the promised land. It's time. I want you to do it. You are no longer an aide. You're a leader. You need to do it. Don't be afraid. Don't be strong and courageous. Don't let anything come upon you. I am with you like I was with Moses. I am with you. There is nothing you need to be afraid of. There is nothing you lack, okay? And you are the same child that Joshua was of God. You have no lack. There should be no fear. There should be nothing but courage inside of you. So break that chain, break that chain, break that chain, and you rise up. Okay, as God's child, as the child of God that God has called you to be, you rise up. I love you guys. I hope you guys have a good day. Bye.